Only a quarter of Monaco's 37,000 inhabitants have Monegasque citizenship. What unites them? The feeling of being part of a big family. In this second episode of Monaco Life, three of them reveal how they contribute to building a strong Monegasque identity, in tune with the times or even ahead of them.
Welcome to Venturi, the Monegasque electric vehicle specialist and the Principality's showcase in the brand new Formula E International Championship. Launched in Beijing in September, it will be in Monaco next May. An obvious choice, according to Michel Ferry, the Principality's Grand Prix racing director.
For 15 years, we've been holding a Monte Carlo New Energies Rally for hybrid, electric and hydrogen cars, and so on. So when the International Automobile Federation suggested they would launch a 100% electric championship, we said, we'll be part of it. We want to take part.
With an average speed of 497 kilometers per hour, Venturi holds the absolute track speed record for an electric vehicle. A real pride for Monaco, whose history has in part been written by car racing for more than a century.
One cannot ignore motorsport when born in the Principality of Monaco. It's an obligation.
After this short trip into the future, it's back in time to discover the secrets of one of the locals' favourite snacks, the traditional Barbajuan. It's Marc Costa's speciality.
The Barbajuan, which is par excellence Monegasque, is still handmade the way Mother showed it to us. You see, it's perfect.
Delicious.
Sold in his 8 bakeries, the Costa Barbajuan is the one to buy in the Principality. But what about the recipe?
It's mostly charred leaves, ham, rice, onions, cheese, eggs.
The filling is wrapped in thin, but not too thin, pastry, then fried in oil. Marc and Alan have been working together for 35 years.
In this picture, you can see my mother, my father, Alain here, as it was taken in 1979, when he had just started, and myself. And we are rolling croissants by hand. Monaco's specificity is duration, it's peace. There is no political change or government change. There's a certain form of general tranquility. All the Monegasque companies, the truly Monegasque ones, work on a long-term basis.
Good morning. I'd like some Barbajuans, please.
Dominique Salvo has a real love for words. She teaches the Monegasque language in Monaco's only state high school, Charles III High School. Since 1976, the Monegasque language has been mandatory from the age of 8 to 14. After that, it can be taken as an option up to university entrance level.
I love Monegasque. I love this language, and I love what it passes on. I find it a delicious language.
For Monaco's pupils, it's a means of identification which enables them to distinguish themselves from their big French neighbour.
As soon as you know a bit of it, everybody knows you're from around here. At the same time, even for foreigners, it's a means of integration.
For Dominique Salvo, perpetuating the Monegasque language is contributing to the construction of national identity.
It comes from Genoa in Italy, but today it's only spoken here. Therefore, to let it vanish is to let it die, and it's a people who loses its language, which is not only vocabulary, but at the same time, it's a way of being, of doing, of thinking. For us, the Monegasque lesson has reached its end. If you love ballet, opera and classical music, don't miss our next edition of Monaco Life. See you soon on Euronews.